Hey guys, I'm Marcus at Shooted Film and Photography, and in this video I'm gonna show you some clips from a corporate talking head setup I did a few months ago. On this assignment, I rigged everything on location at the client's office, so I'm gonna walk you through the entire light setup, the camera gear, all that stuff, and then we will take a look at the final result as well. I normally don't do like a vlog type of thing when I go through my light and camera setup, but on this assignment I actually had time to do that, so here's a try at least. So let's take a quick look at my setup here. This big guy is my, I don't even know what to call it, scrim maybe? I don't know. But we have an aperture 300D Mark II. That I shoot through a Lightone 2 and this scrim. So that makes a very even and soft light, as you can see here. Very nice gradient. And to get rid of some echo, I've just used some blankets, some bed covers, and some moving blankets here. And here we have a aperture 120D Mark II with the Lightone 2 Mini. And as a hair light, I'm just using this little Bowling P1 light, just to get a little touch, a little highlight. This is the Canon C70 with the RF85 F1.2. Very nice, very sharp. And on the back here, we have the built-in screen, and we also have the Atomos Shinobi. This is not a recorder, I have the Ninja as well, but I'm using the Ninja usually on my R5 and the Shinobi on the C70. And here we also have the Sennheiser EWG4, two of those, because we're gonna record two people in the same interview later on. This is a Sackler Activate Flowtex 75 tripod, probably the last video tripod I will ever buy. It features so many smart design solutions, like these red flaps at the top, which releases all the sections at once. And if you want to remove the entire head to put it on a slider, for example, this is also done very easily with a big, nice handle. And it's super easy to balance as well. You just hold the handle, balance the head, and push it down. This is the Activate T version, which is the touch and go version of this head. And this makes a very sounding click when the camera is secured. And to remove the camera from the head, you just release the red switch at the bottom, lift the camera, super easy. It also comes with a very practical carrying handle that I think I've never seen on any other tripod. The Sackler Activate Flowtex 75 is quite expensive, but for me, this tripod feels like a very solid investment. I'm also using this to measure the color temperature of the light. And this is a Seconic C800 spectrometer. And a powder brush with some transparent powder is good to minimize flare and shine in the skin of the persons that I'm filming. I shot this from only one camera angle. I didn't really feel that two camera angles were necessary, because we already had a lot of B-roll to change things up with. And I also knew that we were gonna shoot one person and two persons in frame at the same time, so one camera angle made things a bit easier. Here are the settings I used. We shot everything with the exact same settings, because when everything was dialed in, I knew that we were gonna keep it all the same throughout the entire shoot. And for audio, I used two Sennheiser EWG4 lav mics, like I mentioned before. I think these work pretty well. Maybe not the super duper best sound quality ever, but good enough for this purpose at least. And the receivers I had mounted on the camera cage and plugged into the C70 with XLR to mini XLR adapters. That way I won't have to fiddle around with an external recorder and so on, so that's convenient. Here's how you mount the Tilta full cage kit to a Canon EOS C70. First, a little unboxing. Everything you need is in the package. You have all the accessories, some Allen keys, the base plate and the rods. And this is what the cage looks like. The first step is to remove this tiny little part of the cage on the upper left corner, and this is to make the camera fit inside, and then you reattach it the same way. Next step is to attach two screws at the bottom of the cage, tighten the screws with the Allen key, and you're good to go. Notice that there are two different screws of the same size, so make sure you put them in the correct place or else it's not gonna work. Then you attach the quick release plate to the bottom of the cage, and I call this thing a rod adapter. Don't know if that's the correct word, but this thing makes it possible to attach rods to the back of the plate as well. Then you just put the rods in, make sure they're snug and tight, then you slide the camera in place, lock it with the red handle, and you're done. These top panels are not from Tilta, but I wanted to try how they work on the Tilta C70 cage. The first one is some kind of eBay brand, don't remember where I got it, but it attaches to any cold shoe and you get 3 extra cold shoes on the handle, which can be useful. This other one is a universal NATO top panel from SmallRig, the article number is 2950 if you wanna Google it. And this one is actually one of my personal favorites. I have this top panel on my cages for the R5 and the R6 as well. It comes with a NATO rail adapter which you can mount anywhere you want in case you don't have a NATO rail in the position where you would need it, so this is very useful. And the shape and material of this handle is probably the best I have tried, and for me personally I think that the top handles where you can put one finger in front like this are the best ones, because in my opinion this is the most comfortable and also the safest way to hold the camera. One thing that I have noticed about the C70 is that the image is a bit soft if you compare it to the Canon R5, for example, which is a camera I have as well. And I think that this is on purpose since the C70 is a bit more cinema style camera, so to speak. So to fix this, you can either apply some sharpening in post or you can set up your own custom picture profile in camera, which is what I have done after this shoot. I created my own profile where I cranked up the sharpening and the details quite a lot so that it looks more the way I like it straight out of camera. The parts we recorded in this video was just the talking head material. If you want to, you can take a look at this link, wherever it is on the top, to see how we recorded the B-roll footage from the factory, which I then mixed with the talking head parts in the editing. And let's also have a look at a few parts from one of the final edits for this client. This is in Swedish, of course, so I have lowered the volume here. And when I do edits like this, corporate talking head clips mixed with B-roll, I try to follow the 10-second rule, which Parker Wahlbeck talks about in his full-time filmmaker course. And this means that you should have a maximum length of 10 seconds before you cut to another scene or another camera angle. Because for the viewer, it's gonna be pretty boring to watch 3 or 4 minutes from the exact same camera angle of the exact same person just talking. So I try to stick to the 10-second rule. And if I have enough B-roll material, I usually keep it even shorter than 10 seconds before I cut to another scene. And this video is not gonna be super detailed, so I'm not gonna go into the editing process or anything like that. If you want to check my other videos, I have a lot more detailed stuff on the editing, on the color correction and so on. So, rounding things off here, check out the links on the end screen if you want to get a more in-depth look of how I do various assignments. And I'm going to drop more videos like this from real assignments for paying clients. So, if you want to see more stuff like this, I hope that you will click the like and subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care, stay safe, bye.